Hello, everyone. Thank you so much for coming. I'm so excited to see you all. hi, Anushka. So I think we're going to get started. Welcome. Sweetness, and you fill my head with you. Shall I write it in a letter? Shall I try to get it down? Oh, you fill my head with pieces of a song I can't get out. So that song is called Bloom. It's by the Paper Kites, and I love it. It's on all of my playlists. So I have my family in my room with me right now. So if you hear clapping, that's them. But yes, so the next song I have is an original. I wrote it after I was inspired by a musical theater artist who wrote a one-woman show with just her and her guitar, and it was a comedy. And I thought it was really fun. So I decided to write kind of a funny song with some of my experiences sprinkled throughout. Okay. Sorry. My picking gets a little messy when I'm nervous, so my apologies.
Fall for the curly hair boys who don't know how to dress or lower their voice, and I know I could do better. Guess I'm just filling a void. My standards are lower than my self-esteem, so I'm not surprised when another guy disappoints me. Then I blame it on timing and astrology. I try not to get discouraged. Mistake number one was not listening to myself. Number two was ignoring the warnings I felt. Mistake number three is the worst of all. I let myself fall, thinking I didn't deserve better. Three strikes, I'm out. Time that I learned to move on and give myself room to breathe and really live. I'm reclaiming the power I let them hold over me. Cause in order to be the best I can be, I've gotta let go of people's perception of me. I care too much about how they see. But if I said I'm hopeful, I'd be lying. Mistake number one was not listening to myself. Number two was ignoring the warnings I felt. Mistake number three is the worst of all. I let myself fall, thinking I didn't strikes, I'm out. And it's easier said than done to break a habit. Self-confrontation makes me run the other way. I wanna move on, but some things be undone. I won't give up, won't resign, won't let another waste my time. Something that I finally recognized, the only to never base my worth off stupid guys. Thank you. Thank you. Yeah, gotta have a girl power song in there for sure. Okay, so this next song is from a movie / musical called Once that my family discovered this winter, and it has become a new classic. So I'm inviting my sister Olivia to come sing with me because it has some pretty cool harmonies. So yeah, this is called If You Want Me. Capo first.
So long since I have seen you, can hardly remember your face anymore. When I get really lonely and the distance calls its only silence, I think of you smiling with pride in your eyes.
next song. There are a couple people joining. I'll pause for a second. So the next song I wrote as I was taking my songwriting class, I haven't mentioned yet, but this concert, Tiny Desk Concert, is a culmination of my senior project where I've been taking guitar lessons and songwriting lessons in asynchronous classes online. And my songwriting class was super helpful to me throughout this because it kind of taught me, helped me give structure to kind of how I approach writing a song. And I'm really grateful for that experience. So something that was really helpful to me was learning how to write from a different perspective. And so that's what I did with this song. I took a method that we use called the box method. Liv, will you admit these people real quick?
Yeah.
Thank you. And the box method basically shows you how to progress a song effectively, all while maintaining prosody, which is the general rule of songwriting that everything, the melody, the lyrics, the chords, are all aiming towards the same goal. So it makes sense. But yeah, so this has the box method and also writing from a different perspective, kind of as the method of progression. Sorry, I'm going to start over.
He stares at the sky, waiting for answers to appear. He's lost but at home, feeling lonely, but he's not alone. Thank you. find one like her again.
Yeah. Woo!
Thank you. Okay. Oh. Almost forgot again. Okay. So this next song is called Cherry Wine, and it's by Hozier. He's one of my favorite artists. But this is a song that I started learning way back in March when I first got my own guitar. And I glad to have gotten the chance to work on it a lot during my senior project. It's probably the most challenging song I learned. It has a pretty interesting picking pattern, and I have gotten many calluses and bleeding fingers from this song. But yes, this is Cherry Wine. She shows me I'm hers and she's mine.
is funny. Thank you. So the last song is the song that I sing with my mom at Coffee House, that I wrote just about feelings of leaving, moving on, growing up. So now I'd like to invite her to join me. That is all I have for you today. Thank you so, so much for coming. It means the world to me. And yeah.